This week's training print has been hanging around the top of the list for a little while, and what I like about it is it's completely printed, no other hardware required. So how sturdy is it? Let's print it out and see. In the comments for this model created by Funky Art, a lot of people had issues with the fit of the bolts. For me, the fit was perfect on the large ones as well as the small one for the phone holder part. Now, if you have issues, you could look into your slicer settings to make some minor adjustments using things like XY compensation in Prusa Slicer or in Cura, I think it's horizontal expansion. They can adjust the tolerance of the parts that fit together. Here's all the pieces I needed if you're following along at home. There's a few pieces to print out, and for some reason for me it wasn't super clear from the description exactly what I needed. But once you start printing, it's easy to see what you're missing. And while we assemble that, can you imagine this arm printed in aluminium or titanium? Our sponsor, PCBWay, has 3D printing services with materials you couldn't imagine was possible. You can get parts printed in different types of filament, but also metals, with all the details clearly listed on the website. And don't miss the specials they have for Christmas at the moment. Great deals anytime, but big discounts till December 31. Now back to the print. One problem I did have was the arms rely on the tightness of the bolt to squeeze together and the friction between the parts to hold. I ended up tightening the bolt too much and snapping the head off because the thread was of course pulling the bolt through and the head couldn't go any further. You could add some strength to the bolt in that direction by printing horizontal with supports. It might make the thread a little messy. I think one improvement of the arms is that you could add some notches around the hole to take some of that pressure from the squeeze force to hold the arm up, so you don't need to tighten it quite as much. The only other improvement I can see with this one is the flexibility of the phone holder part. It's a compliant mechanism, so it's one piece with flexible ribs, but for me in PLA, there wasn't a huge amount of flexibility. Good thing was that it's a pretty standard size. The TCL Android phone and the iPhone XS that I tested both fit really snugly. If you do have a big phone, you might need to make some adjustments or look at what remixes pop up on printables. I tried the arm in a few places. For me, my desk isn't really where I think I'd use it. If you have a need, it could be good to record yourself or for Zoom or team calls, if you want to do that on a separate device from your computer. I could see myself using it to watch tutorials at this desk that I have, which would free up desk space and put it in a convenient position for when I'm working. Where I'm likely going to use it though is on my printer to get some overhead time lapse or different angled shots I can't get with the fixed camera without a lot of work to move it around. I also remixed the phone holder end for a standard GoPro style pronged mount. And I've uploaded that to printables if anyone needs it, links in the description. So while some people might not have a need, I think if it's something you were looking at and it fits your workspace, it's a good model. I think this model has huge potential for remixes for different holders or all kinds of different attachments. I'd love to see what people can do. Anyway, see you next week.